now that we got to the electric underhooks, I used to, the first step, the first position in getting to the electric chair used to be a couple different ways. This can work. You can, instead of having electric underhooks here, some people, and I used to do this, I used to grab this here, squeeze, drive my elbow in, and then just muscle and goot it over. Boom, big, huge movement. And that still works. The problem is, you're giving it away. There's no way I'm gonna transition a dogfight if I have this underhook here. So he knows now to sprawl 100%. He's gonna sprawl 100%, and I can't transition a dogfight, so he can use all his energy to sprawl and to defend the one thing. I committed too much. So if I'm here, now, if he commits too much and sprawls 100% here, it's easy for me to get up to dogfight here. So now he's in the middle. He doesn't know if I'm going to dogfight or if I'm gonna dive under for the electric chair. So it makes the electric chair easier, having a threat to dogfight. So now we got the electric underhook. I got the electric underhook. I go to dogfight or electric chair, right away. No hesitation in motion. Makes the guy on top not overcommit. He doesn't overcommit on defense, it's easier, less defense. That's what we want. So when we decide to go for the electric chair, the first move off the double underhooks or the electric underhooks is I want to take him this way. So I'm going to push him the opposite way first so that he pushes the way I want to go. All right, so I'm here. I'm going to just push my chest up and squeeze so that he pushes back, and then we go this way. He's gonna pull out the overhook, his wizard and base, and then we're gonna be in this position here where he's sprawling and I have his leg on my bicep. The goal is to get it right here. But this is where the fight's gonna be. And he's gonna be based out, and he's gonna be trying to go backwards. He's gonna be trying to walk backwards. I'm trying to get that leg on my shoulder. He's trying to sprawl. So you must take this base out. You need to hit that thing. Get it out of the way, and then shuck this leg over your shoulder, clenched on your neck. Once I'm here, now I know I can sweep him. 90% sure I'm gonna sweep him. If I got both of these, I can get on top. If I lose the lockdown, then I don't have it. If I can keep the lockdown and keep this leg here, I can get up. But first, we're gonna check their flexibility. From here, I'm going to get up on my elbow as far away as possible from him. Then I'm gonna re-grip here in the gable grip, and then I'm gonna collapse forward, put my chest on the mat, and stretch the lockdown out. That's the electric chair finish.